Hi everyone, so today I'm going to be giving you a walkthrough of my modelling portfolio. I'll be showing you what to include in there, all of the different sections and some tips along the way. I'll also be giving little story times on the shoots that I have done. Another place that you can find my modelling content is my Instagram. I will leave it linked down below. So please follow me on there and you can see some of the shoots that I'll be talking about. I actually used Wix to build my portfolio. Wix is really good because it's free, it's easy to use. They have really good templates that you can use, so if you don't have any prior website building experience like I don't, you can still easily build a website and a portfolio, and they have everything to cater for that. Right, let's get into it. Okay, so here is my home screen. I've kept it very minimal because I just wanted my font, my letters, my branding and colours and everything to be very classic and reflect me as a person and my branding and the shoot style I want to get into. I wanted to have quite large photos on my screen, just three that just fill up the screen and show and reflect who I am. This is the first one that comes up. This is from my most recent shoot. I love how striking it is with the colours. I think it's a really nice striking photo to have as your first. This next one, I like how my body fills up the whole image, the whole screen, and it reflects that I want to do fashion photography. And then this one is one for my casual shoots, but I really like it. I love how Instagrammable it is. I love this photo. I had to include it. I wanted to keep the sections quite minimal. I didn't want to have too many sections in there, even though I probably could, but I just wanted to have about five or six. So they're all very self-explanatory. I have studio shoots, which is shoots I've done in a studio. I've kept them separate to outdoor shoots, which is shoots I have done outdoors, different lighting, different vibes, so I've separated them. Then there's fashion and runway, which is runway walks or anything really fashion related, even though they're all fashion related basically. They're primarily have that tone to them. And then casual shoots, which is shoots that have just been taken on a phone, not from a proper shoot, but I still think are worthy of being on my portfolio. And then the more section, which is about me. I don't know why it says members, ignore that. I'm not that tech savvy to know how to remove that. But nothing comes up if someone visits your site and presses it. And I like having the sections just here, easy to see. Like I said, I want to keep the website simple for people to navigate. Okay, so let's go on to my first section, studio shoots. Now, as you can see, the layout changes. I wanted to have a lot of images within one page because I just think it's a lot of images that people can see, it catches the eye. The layout I went for on here was called Masonry, I think Masonry. It gets loads of images in one, it keeps them quite tidy still. So as you can see, I've got images, videos. It's so important, I think, to include videos because it just shows people what you're like maybe to work with if it's behind the scenes video, what you're like on set, how you move, mannerisms, show you as a person. I think it's a really good way to show that to people. These photos here, the orange ones, that was for a photo shoot for my final project at uni. So what I'm wearing in the photos, I've made and painted everything I'm wearing. It was taken in the photography studio at my uni. My boyfriend took the photos with his camera. I planned the entire shoot, styled it all, the background, everything, poses, I planned all that. It was a very last minute shoot to do. We didn't have much time in the morning, but we got it done. And yeah, I just love those photos. Again, they're very what I want to go into with the fashion photography. These ones are from one of the first ever shoots I did. These tops, I painted them. And this is the shoot that I mentioned in my first video where I just took the photos myself with a clicker. I've only got a few from this shoot. As it was one of my first shoots, it wasn't the best. But, you know, you've got to start somewhere. Next section, outdoor shoots. So I sectioned these together because it shows how I shoot outdoors with the lighting. So these first ones are for my most recent picnic shoot that I did. I think this is my favourite shoot I've done so far, just because on the day it was just so much fun. We went to a really nice park. I worked with two photographers, so this is only a handful of images. I've got so many images from this. And yeah, I just think they really show, like I took my time to style myself and show that I can style dresses and wear dresses well. And then these images, there's only a few, but these are just from a shoot I did with my boyfriend. Again, another product one, one of mine, so I painted onto this corset top and he took the photos. Again, one of my first shoots, so the photos aren't great, so I haven't included them all, but I've just included like the best ones. Next section is fashion and runway, my favourite section. I'm not going to show the runway ones, just for reasons. If you go onto my Instagram, follow me on Instagram, then you'll be able to see them, all the content from that. These are from my shoot I did in Birmingham. It was really fun. It was my first shoot with a photographer. I think I did pretty well, considering. We went to loads of different locations, and I really enjoyed planning my look for this shoot. As you can see, I thought about my outfit, the colours, how the colours go together, how it would look going round, and it was great because all the windows and everything matched me well. I love that shoot, and I have a lot of images to include from that shoot. It's hard because you want to include a lot of images, but it's also quality, not quantity. So find that balance, you know. I think it's good to show that you can do a variety of different things rather than just unloading all of these images that might not mean anything. Okay, the next section we are on is casual shoots. Like I said, these are ones that they weren't taken by a camera, they were just taken by a phone. It wasn't a planned shoot, but just because they're taken on a phone doesn't mean they're not portfolio worthy or Instagram worthy. You think if you want to work with a brand that's they're looking that you can wear clothes well on Instagram, that you can promote them well on Instagram. These first three here are ones I went to London with my boyfriend and we found some nice looking houses in Kensington. There's plenty there. He took some candid photos of me. I just moved around and he took them. I ended up with really cool poses. These next photos are my favourite photos of me ever. It was on my birthday trip and we went to this really nice bar and it's in front of St Paul's Cathedral. And yeah, these were just at the end of the night, oh, can you take photos of me? And they ended up being my favourite. This one was just taken before going out for my boyfriend's birthday. It's in the mirror. I really want to do a proper mirror shoot because I've seen some really interesting ones and I don't see them done that often. So I want to do that. This one was taken on the day of my birthday. Again, just in the hotel, I was wearing a nice outfit. I just love getting, when you're in a nice outfit, and you have a shoot or you have nice photos of you, I just love it and I just want to reflect how I wear clothes, really. Sounds simple, but I do. And this one, again, getting ready to go out and I just got my friend to take a photo of me. You can probably tell a theme. All of my shoots I'm wearing colour and then all of these I'm in black. So now we've got the about me section, which is one of the most important sections because here is going to give information and give people that line to contact you. I put my age, all of that. Make sure you do know your measurements because people might ask for them as well, so just get a tape measure or maybe get someone to measure you. And then I put a little bit about me, so put where I'm based, put my skill level, although I need to change that because I read somewhere that amateur means bad and I'm not bad. I thought amateur just meant beginner, so I have to change that. I mentioned I've been photographed in a few shoots. Obviously now I've gained a bit more experience, so I do need to update it. I'm looking to gain experience to build my portfolio, which is still true. Seeking trade for pics. Remember, that's what TFP stands for. It's trade or time for pics, because I never knew. Or paid shoots, which I'm wanting to start doing more of now, is paid shoots. And then I put my contact information. Only put contact information that you want people to contact you through. Don't go put in your Snapchat because there's no need. So I've put my Instagram, my email address, my Facebook and telephone number, which I might remove because there's no need for no one to be texting you. Remember, anyone on Facebook that sees this the whatever you link it on, through Facebook groups or whatever, anyone is going to see this information, and you don't want just anyone having your telephone number. There's no need. Everyone contacts you through everything else. And then my message box. So this has been really handy. I didn't know people would use it, but they do. So people just leave their name and their email, and they write to you, and it's really good because it's really, I think it's really professional. When people contact me through there, I'm like, oh, okay, you do want to work with me. That was my portfolio. I hope you enjoyed it and got something from that and maybe got inspired to start your own. It's so easy. There is so many website builders or so many ways you can make a portfolio. Just get making one. If you've got any feedback for me, even if it's constructive criticism for me, let me know in the comments. So please like the video, share it, subscribe to me if you haven't already. I would love that. Thanks for watching. Let me take you back to a time.